There's another really nice area a lot of people love in West Mobile, and it's only 25 to 30 minutes, depending on who's driving, to downtown Mobile, making it even more desirable.
Welcome to our channel, or welcome back to our channel. We're your real estate fam in Lower Alabama, and we post informative videos on YouTube every weekend to show you guys what it's really like to live down here in the deep south. Today's video is especially for people who are planning to move to Mobile, Alabama. We will be sharing the top best places to live near Mobile, and if you were seriously considering a move anywhere in Mobile, I suggest you stick with us till the end.
What's up, everybody? I'm Tony, and this is my partner, Jess. If you're new to our channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button and you tap that little bell so you get notified each and every time we drop a new video. We discuss relevant, updated information in our videos that you can only get from someone who actually lives here. We've been living near Mobile and Baldwin County for quite some time now, so we really know the pros and cons of living down here. We make these videos so you guys know everything you need to know before you decide to pack up your bags and make the move down here. Plus, we're licensed realtors here in the state of Alabama, which means as much as we love making these videos, we love to help you with your real estate needs a little bit more. Our number is popping up on the screen right now, and we are the ones who answer those phone calls and those text messages and those emails. So reach out to us and let's talk. But before then, let's dive right in. Okay guys, today we will virtually walk you through various neighborhoods of Mobile, Alabama. We will start with areas of West Mobile, and then we'll go into Midtown and Downtown as well. So if you're planning to move to the beautiful city of Mobile, I strongly recommend you watch this video till the end, because the top places to live near Mobile, Alabama is coming up next with your local real estate experts, myself and my partner Tony. So the first place I'll be talking about is right near Causey Middle School and West Mobile. It's right at the intersection of Jeff Hamilton Road and McFarland Road. I visit this area quite often and have a lot of clients who live here. And let me tell you, it's absolutely beautiful.
So beautiful.
It attracts a lot of families because it's really close to the middle school. And I've had tons of clients say, Tony, I want to rent or buy a house near a school, and I want that suburban neighborhood feel. So if you also want that, this area might be perfect for you. Baker High School is just right up the road, and then you can find the elementary school on the other side. It's just a great location for families with school-aged children. Jess and I have two kids, and them being in walking distance or close to their schools is a must for us. Sometimes we're running around, showing houses, and we can't always be there to drop them off or pick them up. So if we need to drop them off super fast and just run to our next appointment, it's great because we don't have to drive very far to do that. It works out for the kids too, because then they get to walk home with their friends and play along the way. But let's talk more about the neighborhoods in this area. What an average house looks like, how far is a grocery store, and so on and so forth.
So guys, the first neighborhood I really want to talk about is Polo Place in West Mobile. This is such a popular subdivision that people really want to move into. The average house in this neighborhood, you're going to find 3 and 4 bedroom homes, 2 baths, between 1600 to 2000 square feet. They're very modest sized homes with modest price points, and they're super well built. These houses are so solid. We listed a house in this neighborhood just a couple months ago for a military family, and it sold for $240,000. So this location is perfect. It was perfect for them because they were stationed at the Coast Guard Training Center right here in Mobile. So that is something good to know if you're relocating here for the military. In this neighborhood, you'll see kids playing outside. Everyone is super friendly and waves when you drive past, and it's just a really wholesome place to live. Another great spot is Taylor Subdivision. This neighborhood is right next to Polo Place, and it's a bit more expensive. The homes in Taylor Point are gonna range from around $300,000 to $350,000. You can also expect more spacious houses, with 2 and 3 car garages. You will see a lot of all brick split floor plans with 4 bedrooms, 2.5 baths. They boast a ton of luxurious features like high ceilings, tray ceilings, fireplaces, crown molding, all the bells and whistles. The kitchens usually have granite countertops, that subway tile backsplash that so many people love, stainless steel appliances, and a lot of countertop and cabinet space. These houses, they did not skip a beat. The primary suite usually has tray ceiling as well, a large ensuite bath with dual vanities, a large soaking tub, a separate shower, and an oversized walk-in closet. Like, what more could you want? The houses are just really gorgeous and they make a statement, so it's no surprise so many people dream of moving to Taylor Point. They also recently built a Publix grocery store, which is a total game changer and added a ton of convenience for the residents living in this area.
I needed it.
Yeah, and living close to great schools and the grocery store is a definite perk, and property taxes are also going to be around $700 to $800 per year for both of these neighborhoods, and you cannot beat that.
So all that said, there's another really nice area a lot of people love in West Mobile, and it's only 25 to 30 minutes, depending on who's driving, to downtown Mobile, making it even more desirable. Shadow Creek is an upscale community that offers estate-sized lots in the heart of West Mobile. This community offers wooded lots, sidewalks, underground utilities, a beautiful stone wall entrance with a gorgeous waterfall, elegant lighting throughout the community, just everything you can ask for. It's located right off of Cottage Hill Road, and it's also across from the Isle of Palms, right?
Mm-hmm. That's right.
It's right next to Charleston Oaks too. And these are two of the most prestigious neighborhoods in all of Mobile. They're close to schools, shopping, I-10 is close by for quick commutes to downtown, or to Mississippi and New Orleans, which is like what I wanna do most of the time, because when the Saints are in town, I gotta see them. There's 3,000 square foot minimum and 2.5 story home size restrictions, so you can imagine how big these properties are. They really make a statement. With homes boasting so much square footage, property taxes are gonna be a little bit higher in that subdivision, or these subdivisions, around $3,000 per year. But if you compare that to anywhere else in the US, I mean, you really can't complain.
Yeah. Okay, so since Tony just mentioned it, I have to talk about the neighborhood on the opposite side of Shadow Creek called the Isle of Palm. You will find some of the most extravagant houses down there. This Isle of Palm subdivision is one of the poshest neighborhoods in Mobile, Alabama. It's one of the few gated communities in the entire area of Mobile, and almost all the houses down here are priced at over $1 million. You can find houses in Shadow Creek that are also priced over $1 million, but this particular subdivision just really stands out. And if you love privacy and luxury, you will want to check out Isle of the Palm. This neighborhood is in the city of Mobile, and it's extremely established and beautiful with large spacious houses, and it's just one of my favorite locations. Houses are rarely available, but if you can snag one, you're going to love it.
You're gonna have to jump on it too.
Yeah.
The next area I'm gonna mention is right at the corner of Cottage Hill Road and Hillcrest Road. Let me tell you guys that this spot is very, very popular. We have clients who specifically ask us to find them homes in this area, and the reason why is because there's so much going on around the area. You have shopping, you have restaurants right out your front door, and you can't beat that kind of convenience here. This area tops the charts as the most popular area in Mobile, Alabama that we've been asked to go show. Hickory Ridge is one of the most recognizable neighborhoods in the area. Houses around here are brick and they're pretty modern. They're built on nice sized lots, some at least a half an acre, and the homes have an average of 2,000 square feet. When you walk down the neighborhood, it's so welcoming, and the best part is you can buy a house for like $250,000. This family-friendly neighborhood is known for its Kids Crew Mardi Gras Parade, visits from Santa and the Easter Bunny, and it has an easy access to the Cottage Hill Park Playground and Splash Pad.
Okay, y'all, so the next area is one of the hottest places to live in Mobile right now, and it's called Midtown. Every week I have people asking if there are new properties available in Midtown because they go pretty quick. This is the most walkable area in Mobile, and it has tons of restaurants, some great pubs, and shopping. This area is really picturesque, and there's a ton of historic homes to check out. It's great for families or a night out. You have to visit Old Dutch Ice Cream, Taco Mama, and Rock and Roll Sushi. Tony's not very keen on Rock and Roll Sushi, but I love it. Those are just a few of my favorites, and they're all super fun dining experiences. I love the charming craftsman cottages you'll see here in the historic mansions. They all make such a statement and take you back into time. So many have been renovated and we have these gorgeous craftsman style front porches. There's nothing cookie cutter about this area. There are also a lot of rental options in this area as well. And overall, it's just a cool spot to be in with a lot of action.
Jess is right. The houses in Midtown boast a lot of character. Many are historic and will take you back in time. Just from staring at them, just from looking at it, you can tell.
Yeah, you feel like you're going back in the past.
For me, the first thing I notice when I go to Midtown are the giant ferns, oak trees, and magnolia trees. As you drive down the streets, they form like canopies over you. And it's just like something like you see in a movie.
I remember the first time we drove in Midtown, I was mesmerized by the tunnels of trees we drove through. I had never experienced anything like it. Like the magic and beauty, it just never gets old. I have so many pictures, it's just beautiful.
It really doesn't. And homeowners take pride in their homes, and you'll see front porches so done up, you'd think it's their living rooms. So you'll likely encounter runners, folks just wanting, walking their dogs, or families riding their bikes. Everyone comes to you and just smiles and waves.
With all the amazing food in Midtown, you're gonna wanna stay active. So bike riding is a definite must.
She's not kidding. But now let's talk about downtown Mobile. This is the place in Mobile where you can expect to see some massive houses and southern mansions, but mansions aren't the only type of houses in downtown. You can find average houses, lofts, apartment buildings, and a lot of variety in terms of residential spaces in general. A downtown neighborhood called Oakley Garden District is a great place you should check out if you're planning to buy a house in a walkable area. This area in downtown Mobile is really sought after with beautiful old restored homes. There are also some really good restaurants in the area, like really good. You're a mile from all of our favorite spots in downtown Mobile, like Noble South. I like Roosters. I really enjoy going to Dumbwaiter. Everything is surrounded with live oaks, Satsuma, and Spanish moss trees. I mean, one thing I really love about this neighborhood though is that there are really nice parks to visit. You can ride your bike and take it all in, and just really, really peaceful.
Yeah, and Tony mentions outdoor time so much because we used to live in a place where we couldn't just go outside and ride our bikes. We had to wait for those warm spring and summer months, and they came and went so fast. So living in Mobile and Alabama as a whole, you have the option to just be outside almost every day of the year, and that's like a huge driving factor why we moved here.
Yeah, even when it's raining, I'm okay with it because it's so warm out. It's just something that you need to experience.
All right, y'all, that wraps up some of our top places to live in Mobile. Tony and I shared some amazing insights with you guys and hope the information will help you with your big move. We walked you through some exclusive and popular neighborhoods in Mobile. We love it here and we know the area very well, so make sure you give us a call if you have any questions because we are licensed realtors in the state of Alabama. And just as much as we love making these videos and giving you the rundown, we would love even more to help you with your real estate in Mobile.
We're the ones who answer those phone calls, text messages, and those emails. So if there's something that we can do to help y'all, give us a shout. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel, and we'll catch you in our next video. Also, if there's anything that you'd like us to add, make sure you drop it in the comments below.
Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you next time.